Divine Truth Assistance Group. These group assistance sessions are about putting principles of divine truth into action. This discussion is part of the 2014 Australia Group 1 series. Jesus gives group truth on the subject of physical pain, filmed on the 17th of July 2014 in Monkerai, New South Wales, Australia.
Does everyone understand that principle? You think you do, but what happens when you get pain? If we have some mic, if we can just have some mic runners on each side, if that's possible, sorry. Far away. Yeah, both, you can say what you think.
I just have, while that talk was going on, been reflecting on the situation where I've come across people who have to work really hard as children, and that does do physical damage to their body. And if I understand what you're saying, they will need to...
Can I just correct that statement?
Sure.
Because it's totally incorrect. Working really hard doesn't damage your body at all. Your emotions damage your body.
If your body... Okay.
Since I was 5 years old. When I was 11, I was carrying around 20-foot ladders doing apricot picking in 40 degrees of heat. Does it look like my body's really worse for wear because of it? Every day I do work outside for 4 hours, usually, three, 4 hours, usually.
So what you're saying is that hard work can't damage the body. It's the resistance to having to do it or something along those lines.
No, it's the resistance to an emotion that causes the damage to the body.
I have to sit with that one, yeah.
You know, often you tell yourself these stories, somebody worked hard, that's why they've got... No, it's not. It's got nothing to do with that. It's got everything to do with the emotions that are in the person that causes the damage. When are we going to see that it's the emotions that cause the damage? You see? This is what causes us to take the next step, which is, I'm in pain, now I want somebody else to fix me because I believe that the cause of this pain has got nothing to do with me. But it's your body. How can the cause of your pain in your body have nothing to do with you? It's actually your body. How unfair a system would it be if God created you with a soul and a spirit body and a physical body, and then any pain that's in your physical body was the direct result of someone else's actions? How unfair would that be? What are we really saying whenever we're saying it's somebody else's problem or somebody else's fault or something that happened in our childhood with our own pain? What we're really saying is God made an unfair system, and I'm sorry, he did not. God did not make an unfair system. Everything God has done is love. Everything's based on self-responsibility. So if you're in pain, it's got nothing to do with anyone else other than your own denial of an emotion. And it's time we saw that. And this applies to me too. When I'm in pain, it's the same thing. Does that make sense? My eyesight's still bad. It's my own fault. Something's going on emotionally. Something's getting denied. Do you understand? This applies to all of us without exception. God does not make an unfair system. But, Nina, you can continue with the rest of the statement if you wish.
Okay. Well, what I was... The mic's gone.
Our mic's just died on us.
So the rest of my question was, to heal that, we would need to forgive our parents or no?
Well, you're basically saying the parents were the person that caused the damage to that person because they worked hard when they were a child.
To support the family, etc.
Yeah, and I can't agree with that at all. Like, any damage that happens to my physical body is a direct result of my choices, my own soul-based emotions, right? Now, why I made those choices may have a lot to do with my parents. So why I made the choice to suppress my emotions, why I made the choice to suppress how I feel, may have a lot to do with my parents. And that's the stuff that I'll need to work my way through and forgive, and that will definitely heal my body as I do that. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that was my question.
Yeah, but it's got nothing to do with how hard the person was worked and all of those physical issues. Nothing.
Sure, yeah.
And we need to see that. It's got nothing to do with the physical issues. Right.
That's clarified.
If we just go straight behind you to Paige.
So, Jesus, me being one of the people that Deidre would come to.
Does the chiropractic adjustments, yes.
Yeah, for the well, for everyone, but the average person that would come to see me,
yep,
I'd be better off not even touching their body and just talking to them about why it is that they want me to fix it, and
yeah,
and,
that's what
and
I
that
do.
It's about yeah. their emotion
that's
that
they're
not
yeah.
willing to feel.
Yeah.
And now, just leave it with that and see how it goes.
What would happen to your business if you did that?
I'd go broke probably. Yeah,
exactly. You would. You yep. would go broke.
Yep.
Why?
Because not many, well, I've just had an experience of it doing a locum for 6 weeks, seeing 40 people a day. There were maybe 3 out of that day that were open.
To even
to
hearing
even
why.
Discussing the possibility of there being something other than it not being their physical body.
Yeah, discussing the possibility that the pain in their physical body was caused by something they were doing.
Yes.
Yeah.
I really didn't want to hear that.
So what would happen to the to a chiropractor who basically made this change in their practice, and they only treated the people who desired to know the emotional reason why they had the problem?
What would happen?
What would happen, yeah.
I probably wouldn't be seeing many people.
No, you'd probably mainly
I'd be
see
doing
one
other
person
things.
A day or 2 people a day.
Yeah.
And to make ends meet, you'd have to charge $200 a person, wouldn't you? And, of course, everybody would then think she's too expensive. She doesn't do any good for me anyway. She puts it all back on me.
Yeah, so and all she does is talk to me.
And all she does is talk to me, so I don't want to go and see her anyway, right? So in the end, you'd be broke and you'd have to change professions.
Yeah.
That's the sad state of today's medical profession. Today's medical profession is geared around your addictions. Your addiction is to go to somebody else and ask them to solve your problem for you. That's your addiction. You don't see, and most people don't see, the real cause of the problem, right? So here we're talking about challenging addictions. If we were really challenging addictions, we'd go, every time I've got pain, I know I've caused it. Now, it's one thing then to go and get help from somebody to help assist you access that pain, work out what the cause is, work out what the solution is. All that's okay. I don't see any problem with that. But go to someone who's educated with the relationship between the emotion and the physical symptom. Because otherwise, you just adjust the physical symptom, and of course, the emotion 2 weeks later has created the same physical symptom. Again and again and again. And so you go back and you go back, and eventually the doctors get tired of seeing you, of course, because there's no real solution. And so what they do is they start pumping you with drugs that hopefully numb you more from the problem. And then you say, oh, I'm all fixed now because I've just taken 5 drugs that helped me get the problem solved. Now, the medical practice needs to change markedly, but the medical practice is just responding to your addictions. That's all they're doing. We can't blame them for just responding to your addictions. Let's face it, you respond to other people's addictions all the time. Other people respond to your addictions all the time. You can't then expect a practice, like a medical practice, to not do it. You've got all these demands coming out of you. What happens when you don't get them met? You know, there's the rage that comes along with it. How, I went to that person and, you know, he didn't do a thing for me, and I paid him $300, he didn't do a thing for me. Who are you basically saying is the cause of the fault of your own body? That person, for not fixing you, doing something for you to fix you. Right? We've got to start seeing this as a big problem. Yeah. Now, in terms of what you do with a personal practice about it, well, that's challenging.
I know.
Yeah, because it means that you're probably going to have to change from, you know, doing the adjustments to doing a mixture of adjustments with identifying the actual problem from an emotional perspective. And then eventually there would also be the issue of who are the people coming along to you who actually want to resolve the emotion in comparison to the people who just want you to come along and their body and relieve them for 2 weeks. Would you really be loving them by doing that all the time, relieving them for 2 weeks, relieving them for
no.
2 weeks again and again and again?
And it's I can start to feel the pain of it now.
Yeah, you wouldn't
well,
be loving them. So it's challenging,
good.
Isn't it? How do you change your practice from doing what the world currently does to doing it God's way? Well, with a lot of effort and a lot of personal changes in the way you think. You need a lot of trust in God that you're actually going to get some kind of income from this, you know, otherwise you might starve to death if you keep doing it, right? There's all these kind of things that come up with regard to changing the way that you deal with people to be in line with or in harmony with the truth that they created this pain. Their sole choice to deny something created this pain. And unless my feelings are, unless that person acknowledges that, it is very, very hard to give them any permanent help at all. Very hard. Because there's all sorts of unloving things involved with giving them that permanent help. Right, so it's very, very part. Now, well, I won't get into discussion about the rest of that. I want to, the main focus of that was, when you feel pain, it's because you're already in the addiction of denying the emotion. You're already there. And on top of that, if you think of where you go to solve this pain, demonstrates some of your addictions as well. So if I go to a chiropractor every 2 weeks, which I used to do, by the way, my neck used to go out on like clockwork every 2 weeks. So what I did was I went and got a medical insurance so that I could go to the chiropractor every 2 weeks without costing me a fortune, right? And so I basically what I did was I asked other people to share in the cost of me denying an emotion and going to a chiropractor every 2 weeks, and they had the share in the payment of it by my sharing in the insurance program. And then I'd go there and the chiropractor would click, click, bang, 2 seconds and it was fixed, you know. Every time it was the same place, same vertebra, same problem, every time, bang. Oh, relief, beautiful now. Oh, God, I can face the world for another 2 weeks now. No desire whatsoever to find out the reason. Now, there's one chiropractor, the poor fella, he treated me for 7 years like that every 2 weeks. And he was like that with every one of his patients because he had no desire to actually find the cause himself. And, of course, why would you try to help somebody find the cause who doesn't want to find the cause? Right? So you can't blame him. But if he'd said to me, you know, your cause is emotional, back then I might have listened, right? But nobody ever said that to me. They said, oh, yeah, your T number one or two is out, and this is if I do this and do that. And I'd feel it, and I'd go, yeah, it's not back in yet. Sorry, there needs to be something else, and you give it a bit more of a yank, and it's all done. And I'm out the door. Another $40 or $50 gone out, but that wasn't my problem. I only paid 18 of it. And all of you, the rest of the people who subscribe to the same medical plan, paid the rest. And then I walk away and go, yeah, I'm so loving, aren't I? I'm so developed. Yeah, sure. All right. Who is next?